Hello and welcome to this episode of Hampton Roads Business Live. My name is Rory Graham and I'm your host. And today we have the pleasure of having with us Otis Hooper from the Peninsula Boxing Academy. Welcome.
Welcome.
It's been a real pleasure talking to you. I've had two occasions, once on the phone and once before the interview, of sitting down and really having a conversation about you. And I tell you what, after that conversation, I had a whole different feeling about boxing in general and certainly about your program. Why don't you start off by giving us an overview of what is Peninsula Boxing Academy?
The Peninsula Boxing Academy was incorporated in 2005, and the reason for incorporating Peninsula Boxing was to give the youth, juveniles, an opportunity to use their frustration, redirect their frustration into a constructive, educational, motivating program. And at the same time, they would become community leaders. And this is what the boxing program was designed for developing juvenile program that they could be constructively in.
Okay, and now let's, okay, so we're gonna get into that more here in a minute. Let's start with what your background is and how you got involved in this.
Okay. I'm a 6-degree black belt in Taekwondo. That's Korean karate.
And that's how come I haven't ticked you off.
And back in the early days, 1972, 73, I was fortunate enough to have a chance to work with Bruce Lee, Chuck Norris. Wow. And this was the beginning of what we call today kickboxing. Mm-hmm. But back in those days, it was called full contact. And I was ranked number one in the world in the karate world as a competitor. Wow. Now, I wanted to learn to use my hands better because Bruce Lee had influenced my instructor, Jun Ri, to use your hands more. Taekwondo is 70% kicking. So, Jun Ri decided we start to learn to use our hands better. I'm living in Washington, D.C. In Maryland was Sugar Ray Leonard's gym. And, of course, Sugar Ray Leonard had just won the gold medal at the Olympics. Mm-hmm. So, I decided I would go to his gym, learn to use my hands better as a boxer would. My kicking was superb. I was approximately 30 years old. Dave Jacobs, Sugar Ray Leonard's coach, did not want me there. So he said, I was over the hill, too old. He had younger boxers to work with. But he couldn't stop me from coming. If I wanted to come, fine, I may come, but I'd be basically on my own. So for 5 months, I came to the gym to learn to use my hands. Every Tuesday and Thursday, I would go to learn to use my hands as a boxer would. And after approximately 5 months, then he started to train me. I started to compete as a boxer and a professional. I had a winning record when I retired from the boxing world. But that was, again, I started very late. I was just turned 30 years old. That is how my boxing career started. Then I moved to, I'm a Howard University, school trained architect. And I moved to Virginia, back to Virginia. I was raised in, born in Baltimore, Maryland. Early age, my family came to Hampton, Virginia. Mm-hmm. That's where I went my formative school. Then I went off to college, Howard University in Washington, D.C. For about 14 years, I practiced architectural. This was the same time I'm learning to box. And I come back to Washington, to Virginia, worked at the shipyard as a nuclear engineer in the design department. In 86, I decided to leave the shipyard and start my own business. And I was teaching Taekwondo. And then later on, I started teaching the boxing classes.
Well, let me ask you, when we've talked originally, you asked me a question, you said, what is boxing? And I gave you my answer, which was probably what most people think. And then you proceeded to tell me what boxing was, which I found to be very instrumental in your teaching of it and why it's so popular, because you have a very successful boxing academy over there.
What is boxing? Boxing is two people in a ring with gloves on their fists attempting to hit each other while not getting hit. Now the key word is not getting hit. Our school motto is don't get hit. Again, that's one of the understand what boxing is. The other side is, boxing is physics. Now, what is physics? Physics is math. that explains energy and motion. Mm-hmm. Well, boxing uses energy to get the motion. Therefore, boxing is physics. Mm-hmm. So when I'm teaching my students boxing, I'm teaching them physics. I talk to them about Sir Isaac Newton and his laws, first, second, third laws, and how boxing applies to these laws. The same thing with aviation. Everybody knows aviation. In order for a plane to fly, it has to deal with these laws of aviation, which is the same as physics. So when I teach boxing, I'm actually introducing them to aviation. So boxing, and like I say, our motto is don't get hit. So I teach them how not to get hit, applying the laws of physics.
Okay, that's a good answer. All right, and so what is the purpose and the mission of the academy?
The purpose of and the mission of the academy, again, as I said earlier, and that is for the youth to have a program where they would actually redirect their frustration, build up their confidence, self-esteem, and within the program to do this, I require them to bring me their report card. And they must maintain their grade point average or improve their grade point average while in the program. So every marking period they bring me their report card, and if they need help in a subject, I will get someone from the local colleges, Hampton University, Christopher Newport University, to tutor that student to increase his, get his grade points up. That is what our boxing program is all about.
Yeah, but the parents love that.
The parents love it because they realize that boxing is not really a career. When you pass the age of 35, your boxing career is over. Big money-making days are over. But when you are 35 and you have that college degree, now after 10 years of working in that field, you're 35 years old, the big corporations now want you. Now comes your big payday. Mm-hmm. So that's why I emphasize education within my boxing program.
Okay. Well, that's that. Like I said, I'm sure the parents love that. What is the tuition, and what do they get for the tuition?
When a person first calls, first thing they want to know is, how much does it cost for a boxing program? And of course, I need to know, is it for themselves or for someone else? Have they had any training in boxing? And of course, they will answer me. And I explain to them the first thing they must do, since they have not had any training, is go through what we call the Introductory Orientation Program. And that's a $50 fee. And for that $50 fee, they would receive their boxing hand wraps, their boxer's jump rope, their boxing booklet, and they will receive three classes, approximately 55 minutes each. Class one is on the offense, class two is on the defense, and class three is on hitting the different bags, the heavy bag, speed bag, doubling ball bag, rapid punch bag, focus pad. They'll spend 2 to 3 minutes at each one of these stations understanding about developing speed and power in their punches. Once they completed these three classes, they now know if they want to continue in the boxing program. If they want to continue to the boxing program, they may sign up for one of the sessions. We have a winter session, spring, summer, and a fall session. Each session goes for approximately 8 weeks. And that's $150 tuition for the session that they decide to sign up for. Mm-hmm. And then, of course, the equipment, there's approximately $65, $70 for the equipment that they would need.
Oh, that's real reasonable. Yeah. Okay. All right. And so that initial $50 gets them to a lot of, first of all, education in it, but it allows them to determine whether this is something they're really interested
that
in.
That is exactly
before
true.
They get into it and find out they just blew the money on something they're not interested in.
This is something that other boxing schools do not do.
Right.
And the person will get into it, sign up for a boxing program, and they find out this is not what they really want.
Right. Well, I can
so
see that.
This is the reason why, again, I teach my program through the City of Newport News, Parks, Recreation, and Tourism. And this is very successful for the parents to get a feel of the program.
Now, speaking of the parents, and I think you kind of touched on this already, but, you know, parents see the Rocky movies and all that, and also, what do you tell them that they're getting ready to send their little boy or girl into this
arena?
Arena, yeah.
What I say to the parents is, now that your son, your daughter, has taken an interest in boxing, we'd like for you to know and understand, they're not going to be getting into a ring, punching each other in the face. This is a beginner program, a startup program. And this program is designed to build up their confidence, their self-esteem, develop discipline. And this will help them to redirect their frustration, as most teens have. and get rid of some of the stress. Mm-hmm. So that's what I tell the parents. This is a beginner startup program, and they're not going to be getting in the ring, not until they've had at least 4 to 6 months of training, they're qualified, and want to do so.
And I'm sure your program has rules and regulations.
We do have rules and regulations. I'll give you one example. The student wants to compete, or he wants to get in the ring, he wants to spar with someone. He must have completed all the beginner, intermediate lessons, defense and offense. He must have signed up with the U.S. United States Amateur Boxing Association. That's a required because insurance kicks in. And he must take a written exam. I am the only school that I'm the only school that required him to take a written exam. And this is a 5-page exam that they have to take. They have to answer these questions, understand nutrition, vitamins, proteins, how the muscles, how it affects the muscles. They have to understand the history of boxing. This is what my, so now, if they can answer these questions, and they have these rules, and the rule is you are not allowed to train anyone or show anyone any of these techniques. You're not allowed to compete for any other school unless you get permission from our school, from the Peninsula Boxing. You're required to show respect to your mother, to your father, to your parents, your teachers, and to any adults. Again, we have what we call the abusive words. You're not allowed to use abusive words or four-letter words. Now, everybody smile. What is the four-letter words? I can't. Quit. It's too hard. Not allowed to use those four-letter words. Abusive language, we all know what that is. And then, of course, noise, too much talking. We ask them to taper it down. They're not to show anyone any of these outside of the boxing arena, any of these techniques. These are some of the rules that we ask.
Right. Okay. And now you mentioned aviation before and the boxing and aviation kind of.
I will tell you, you can talk to any boxing coach and he will not know that aviation and boxing fits like a glove, hand in a glove. All the principles that you find in boxing is also in aviation. All the formulas, equations, and aviation is in boxing. If you want to do an uppercut with the fist, you want the airplane to go up, you use the elevators. You want the airplane to turn left or right, that's called a hook. You use the rudder. You want the airplane bank left and right?
A lot of similarities.
There's so many similarities in the aviation world and in the boxing world. You have the three axes in aviation, the same three axes in boxing. You have the five negative and positive principles in boxing, you have the same five in aviation. Mm-hmm. So when I'm teaching my students boxing, I'm introducing them to aviation. And I let them know that because this could be a real career and this is the reason why they want to get those grades up.
Okay. And so you have a message for future students that might be watching this?
For the future students, yes I do. And that is, boxing is an excellent program to get into to, like I say, relieve frustration, redirect your anger if you have anger management problems. But keep in mind that education is number one. And without the education, you're not going to be able to read your contract and understand your boxer's contract. You think you're going to get $1 million. But because you weren't doing your English and getting your English down well, your contract, you're going to find out when you get that check, is only $130,000. You want to understand about your math. Get your math down. Because when you get that contract, you're not understanding percentages that you have to pay your trainer, your manager, your cut man, and your sparring partners. They get a percentage. If you don't understand your math, then you're going to find out that your check is going to be a lot less than what you thought it would be. So education.
And of course, whatever field you want to go into after
field,
your boxing
exactly.
career.
Exactly. So I leave a word to you. Boxing's great. Get that education. Come on in. Sign up, and I will help you.
That sounds like something every parent would like to be involved in with their children. Is there anything that I've left off that you wanted to mention?
Well, I'm trying to think if there's anything I may want to say, and that is, at this moment,
no.
I can't think of anything.
Well, see, I did a good job.
I think it's excellent. Okay. I hope I've answered all of your questions.
I think you have. All right. Well, I'll tell you what, I was really impressed with our conversations, and I think you'll be impressed, too, if you give Mr. Hooper a call, and he's available to talk to you. He'll give you a call back if he's in a boxing session, but you can contact him at the Peninsula Boxing Academy. The number and contact information is at the end of this video, and it's also at the bottom of this page. So if you have a child that you would like to get started in the sport of boxing, or might be considering that, give Mr. Hooper a call. I think you'll be surprised.
Or they can call the City of Newport News Parks and Recreation and Tourists, and they will give them even more information.
Okay. Well, I wish you a great deal of success. It sounds like you're having that already, but I wish you a great deal of success and in the future, and I thank you for coming in.
Thank you for inviting me.
All right.